Okay, so Dave here. I decided to take the Swan unit back, and so I ended up getting this at Costco. Came with four cameras. It's a heck of a lot better. The cameras are much more high res, and virtually it works exactly the same as the Swan. It's got all the specs on here. The cameras are 720 by 240. Okay, so they're actually better than 400. So there's the outside of the box anyways. So I've got my unit all set up. I got two cameras installed already. I mean installed really good. I put in conduit and everything. So here's one of the cameras here. And the nice thing about it is the wire goes down through the mount, so there's no wire to be cut going from the camera to your feed. So what I did was I mounted these on octagon waterproof PVC octagon boxes, and then was able to wire them in with the coax and everything. So these see a lot further in the dark. They're a lot brighter. You got your standard BNC and barrel plug on the end. So anyways, there's the image on the TV. I just get the remote control here. And there's the box right there, so that's the DVR right down there. So I'm just going to go through some of the menus here. So I've got mine set up on motion control. So if I want to look at camera number one, from the screen, all I have to do is push the one button on the remote control. I don't know if you can see that, but that image is just absolutely clear. There's no real noise in it or anything, right? Very, very, very clear. There's channel two. I gotta cut this bush down here. Right here. It's kinda in the way. So anyways, I'm going to a menu here. Here's all your options, right? You got display, record, search, network, alarm, device, system, and advance. So you do everything right from here. Or if you want to play back video, just hit the play button and it pops up this little box here. So it's got today's date on it. So if I put a search in now, it'll highlight all the times here on 24 hours where the camera has actually picked up activity. So just after midnight, just after 1, just after 2, just after 3, at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and just before 11. So, and those are in like half hour sections, I believe. And you can hear that beeping noise. It just picked up that car driving by. So it'll do a short recording for that. So rather than use this menu thing, I use the event search. And then you can tailor what you wanna. Say I just wanna look at channel one stuff. So go down to the bottom to search here. And this will pull up all the stuff that's happened. And it will show you the date, the start time, the end time, and the size of the file. So they're very small little files, well compressed. So here's an example of what it looks like in night vision on my porch. So as you can see there, it picks up everything. Here's where the main light is being picked up by white objects in the image. Here's the light from the other camera. You can see it. So now you can fast forward through this, and it will basically take me through all the images that were recorded. So that was at 12. Here's one at 5 in the morning. Here's one at 6 in the morning. Here's another. There's a snow plow going by. Sidewalk plow. There's 7 in the morning. There's 20 to 8. And these are all separate recordings. Every time the screen kind of flashes a bit, that's all separate recording. There's 9:15. 9:03. 10:35. 11 o'clock. Now, as I said, these have tripped for a reason, right? So let's just see why. Okay, here. This one. So this one would have. Anyways, it took me out. So now I'm just going to go down and see if I can find that one. It was 11. I think it was this one right here. So see, that's the neighbor pulling up in his little black car. Now, I really don't need that kind of information there. And you can set that up in the motion sensing area setup. There's little squares that pop up on the screen, and you can actually turn them on and off. So I could actually, you know, turn off everything from here up, so that anything out on the road doesn't affect the trigger. I just hit stop here, and we'll go and look and see if there's anything else here. Nope, that's it. So now you can back this up to a USB drive if you want, and it also comes with a utility to convert the file into an AVI file. So if you wanted to use it for something, or like if you wanted to, say, make a video out of it, or keep it as an actual video file. Now here's all the alarm 2, channel 2 alarm. So this is looking out through the front window. See, now it was triggered by that car going by. Now, as you can see here, like I said, I gotta trim this bush or move the camera. So again, this will let me go through all the images. This is 4:35, that's 5:41. So yeah, that's the sidewalk plow going by there. Of course, once the sun comes up, 7:33. Now I've got it on fast forward here. It's 16 times fast forward. So things are flying by pretty quick. There's 7:41, 7:42. Okay, so I'm just gonna back this up. So here, this is where it triggered because somebody was walking by. And when the picture flashes, that's the end of the recording. Okay, so we're getting motion on the other side of the street now. So anyways, that's basically how it works. See what the log shows. Yeah, it's more or less the same stuff. And you can play back from here as well. Okay, so we'll go back out to the menu Here's where you would set up your recorders and schedule them. That's how you schedule them. You can have them continuously record or just on motion. That's how I've got them set up. And then set your frame rates and your quality. Search. Same as what came up when I hit play. That's the network information. Here's your alarms, which includes the motion. So here's how you would set up the area. We just say, we'll check to 2 here. You can see where I've got it tailored. So you see that? Anything in red is where it records. Anything that's not in red is it doesn't pay any attention to it. So once I trim that bush, I'll be able to make it all red. Device. This is your hard drive and your external hard drive. So you can format it and all that stuff. It'll automatically overwrite recordings when the hard drive is full. There's your system information. Users at the top there. And info. And then the advanced settings. When you want it to reboot and so on and so forth. So that's basically it. So I'm really happy with this one. I just got to install the other 2 cameras and out the back, and I'll be all set. So thanks for watching.